This Latineal team lines out as follows. In goals, Mark Kelly. The back line, Danny McMullen, Francis McIldowney, Declan Kearney, Adrian Quigg, Francis McIldowney, and Conan Cassidy. In the middle of the park, we have Shane Kelly and Bernard Bradley. The forward line is as follows. Larry Bradley, Kevin O'Neill, Martin McIldowney, Patrick Bradley, Niall Convery, and Paul Bradley. Clonoe team, in goals, Jared Kerr. Full-back line, Gary Coney, Shane McCann, Declan Hughes. Half-back line, David Hanna, Emmett McTague, and Jason Burns. Middle of the park, Paddy Hughes, Colm Donnelly. Forward line, Gary McCabe, Martin McHughes, Barry McNally, Ryan O'Neill, Paul O'Neill, and Colm Doris. The game has now kicked off. Fairly liberal passage of play. Clonoe basically taking the upper hand. Rambo O'Neill strikes a left footed shot wide. Quite a sizeable crowd has gathered for the game at Greenlock, and conditions are quite good. Excellent kick by the Slagnell keeper Mark Kelly, broken down to Brian McNally, and the passing play is broken down by McIldowney. Fine passage of play by Slagnell. Kevin O'Neill first to the ball, breaks it down to himself, goes for the score, unfortunately it's wide left. Francis McIldowney clearing up the kick out from Clonoe. On to Paul Bradley, cleverly holding on to the ball, plays it out to McIldowney yet again, who's blocked down well by Clonoe. The centre half back, Emmett Teague, instrumental in breaking down that attack. The resulting free is kicked high, wide and left by the rector. Another good kick out, 45 metres, fielded well by Shane Kelly. Clever ball backwards, determined play, earning the free by Martin McIldowney. Niall Convery with the free kick, similar position to the last kick. About 40 metres as he strikes the ball. Again, high left and wide. Slagnell's early dominance isn't being punished on the scoreboard, unfortunately. Clonoe find themselves quite lucky not to be 2 points down. Shane Kelly again at midfield, masterful. Some dogged play by Dermot Hughes, and cornerback for Clonoe, Lays the ball out well. Clunet begin to build from the half-back line. Martin Hughes takes quite a heavy challenge as he was kicking the ball, and the free will be taken from where the ball lands. Free kick was hit well. Unfortunately, it was wide before it was palmed back into play. Ryan O'Neill was unfortunate with the effort. Slatnil can find themselves lucky to have dealt with the ball. Kelly's kick out for Slatnil, as usual, very, very accurate. That's a line ball to Clunet. Sheen Kelly finding his way into the referee's notebook. Unfortunately, Clunet gift possession back to Slatnil. Slatnil now building from the back through Michael Downey. It's possibly too long with the ball. He has gained the free. Paul Bradley in possession for Slatnil. Holding the ball well. That's a fine right-footed score. Excellent point by Paul Bradley. Well received by the crowd. Bradley breaking the ball down to Jason Burns for Clunet. Clunet opting for the slow build-up. Hughes now in possession of the ball, carrying well. This is an exceptional footballer. Has an excellent left-footed score. Martin Hughes, as you know, will be on the verge of an under-21 call-up for Tyrone. Deadly from play and from the dead ball. Quite a scrappy bit of play. Slatnil cleaning up well, defending in numbers. The race is on for the ball. Sheen Kelly conceding the free kick to Clunet. Martin Hughes again in possession of the ball. What a fluent runner we have here. Onto McNally. McNally unfortunately slipped the ball right to the fullback. Cassidy finding quite a bit of difficulty picking up the ball nicely now. On to Michael Downey. Michael Downey with a low ball into Bradley. Bradley fouled as he was trying to collect the ball. This should result in quite an easy free for Slatnil. Bradley opting to kick his own free, converts with ease. Michael Downey again picking up the loose ball with the assistance of Bradley, who's now carrying the ball to the left wing, opting for the long ball into Kevin O'Neill. Unfortunately, he's broken down by Emmett Teig at centre half back for Clonoe. Clonoe defending in numbers. Slight bit of afters here. The referee opting to stamp his authority on the game. Kevin O'Neill finding himself into the book. From the free kick from Emmett Teig. Clonoe now in a flowing movement forward. Colm Donnelly carrying the ball. Plays the educated ball. That's an exceptional goal by Paul O'Neill, the full forward. He's hit the top corner from 20 metres. That's a devastating blow for Slatney at this early stage of the game. Neither team really varying the kick out, opting for the long punted ball down the centre. Barry McNally played the ball through, dealt with by Shane Kelly for Slatneal. Niall Convery for Slatneal, possibly their most dangerous player going forward, laying the ball back to Michael Downey. An educated footballer looking for a player. O'Neill finding himself in a bit of space in the corner. Will he make the ball? He has kept it in well. Opting out for Convery. Convery carries, beats one man, beats two men. Lovely dummy sidestep and an excellent left foot finish. Convery is obviously one for the future, both for the Emmets and hopefully for the county. Referee starting to get slightly impatient with the car and the nets for Clonoe. As he strikes the ball, it's a fine kick out. Kelly again breaking down. Michael Downey on hand as per the norm to clear up any loose ball. O'Neill collecting his ball forward and is fouled. About 25 metres out on the left-hand touchline. This will prove to be a hard kick should they opt to go for the score. David Handa finds himself in the book for the free on O'Neill. He lofted ball into the square, going harmlessly wide. Colin Cassidy for Slatneal. Larry Bradley playing a ball through to Niall Convery. Niall Convery again finds himself loose. Ball's tidied up nicely by Gary Coney and cornerback for Clonoe. Emmett Teg playing the ball back to Coney. Coney centering the ball to Donnelly. Donnelly to Hughes. This is a fine flowing movement. Martin Hughes, exceptional footballer, left footed score, excellent point. Cleno going forward with some determination and again add to the scoreboard. We find ourselves at Cleno 1-2 to Slattenhill not 3. 2-point advantage, which is a fair reflection of the game. Gary Coney letting the ball go past him. He's helped out by his colleagues in defence, playing measured 1-2s. This is fine play by Cleno. Colin Doris with a fine ball into the corner. Laid back for Donnelly. And Collie Donnelly in the right wing. Collie is a minor player for Tyrone. Surely fouled as he was striking the ball. Yes, indeed. We have a Cleno penalty. Martin Hughes quite confident stepping up and asking for the ball to strike the penalty. Hughes deliberately strokes the ball with the instep of the right boot, narrowly shaving the post. Excellent penalty. Cleno again stretches their lead. They are now 5 points to the good. Yes, convert more of their possession into scores. Ball broken down. McNally getting his boot to it first. On hand to tidy up for Slattenhill. Fouled while he was kicking the ball was Larry Bradley. Slattenhill are faced with the option of a kick on the 45-metre line. Played into Paul Bradley. Slid the ball to his midfield partner, Bernard Bradley, who unfortunately was blocked down as he hit the kick. Duras in possession for Cleno. Slips the ball out to O'Neill. O'Neill, great ball forward. Hughes again, front of his man, first to the ball. One-time ball into the full forward, collecting the ball, fouled in the process. The Slattenhill fullback finding himself in somewhat distress. Adrian Quick yet another with the Emmett's player finding a way into the keeper's notebook or the referee's notebook. Curtis, a slight indiscrepancy with McNally. Just burns up for the high lofted ball forward. Slattenhill dispatching the ball out to the sideline with a fist, leaving Cluno with the resulting sideline ball.
Must be 6 points.
Ball collected by McNally in front of the net, opting for the fisted score. Unfortunately, Cleno could not meet the ball. Larry Bradley in possession for Slattenhill. Slipping the ball inside. Well played. Back to Bradley. Slattenhill starting to find their stride. Unfortunately, the ball forward was not as accurate as it needed to be. Slahnil making a change. We have Patrick Bradley coming on for the recently booked Adrian Quigg. Clonoe again in possession of the ball. Unfortunately, the referee was not happy with the position of the sideline kick and has asked for it to be retaken. Collie Doris, very first of the ball, carrying well, looking for help. Connor Donnelly on hand, slips the ball inside. Kevin Doris with a fine kick, that's wide right. For Clonoe, himself a county minor. Ball play forward with Jason Burns. Unfortunately, Ryan O'Neill was too slow coming to the ball. To the Slahnil fullback, Michael Downey steps inside his man, dispatches the ball. And Paul Bradley has now picked up the ball on the left touchline. Been well shepherded by Gary Coney. Bradley finds his way forward. O'Neill collects the ball, fisted across the face of the net. Convery with the shot and a goal. Slahnil are now back in the game, courtesy of the Rector's left-footed shot. Clonoe varying the kick out to Colin Doris. Emmett Tay collecting the ball from him. This red-headed man is going forward with quite a rate of knots. Slips the ball to Donnelly. Donnelly with a fine ball forward. Well cut out by the Slahnil Danny McMahon. Laying the ball out to Conan Cassidy. Cassidy collects his own error. Convery now finds himself in possession of the ball. Opting for the low punted ball forward. Kevin O'Neill down, trying to collect. The ball going for the Clonoe kick. That's well held by Michael Downey, fullback, playing somewhat out the field. Carrying the ball well. Has beaten three men to the stage. Ball collected with ease often by Doris. Plays the long ball forward. Declan Kearney, cornerback, tidying up for Slahnil. Ball slipped to O'Neill, to Hughes. Kearney goes down for Slahnil, collects the ball. Somewhat scrappy play. Feeds it out to Bradley. Back to Kearney. Kearney forward to Convery. Convery in the middle of the field. Eggers of possession. Michael Downey now picking up the ball, carrying forward at rate of knots. His right footed shot going wide right. Broken down from Burns, who collects it. Collie Doris in possession of the ball, carrying forward, buying time for his forwards to get into position. That's fine running with Paul O'Neill. Plays the ball forward. Ryan O'Neill, back to Paul O'Neill, going forward. Left footed shot over the bar. Excellent score. McNally carrying the ball forward for Clonoe. Slaniel cornerback doing very well and trying to gather possession, earning the free. Patsy Bradley to McIldowney. McIldowney forward to Bradley again. Bradley collects the ball. Back to McIldowney. Patsy Bradley unfortunately not collecting the ball. Burns in possession. Slips the ball to Hughes. Hughes to Colley Donnelly. Colley Donnelly forward. Ryan O'Neill now in possession of the ball. McNally with the right footed shot wide. Cleaning up possession, fouled in the process. The early ball to Combrey. Back to Combrey. Now Combrey carrying the ball forward. Slips the ball inside. Martin McIldowney for Slattenhill. Earns a free. Paul Bradley kicking the resultant free wide. Free kick forward to Shane Kelly. Bending, collecting well. McIldowney and Patsy Bradley. Unfortunately, it's wide again for Slattenhill. Half time approaching. We find ourselves with Clonoe 2-3 to Slattenhill at 1-3. The game really is as tight as that. There's one kick of the ball between the two teams. midfield for Slaughter Neil collecting the ball. Michael Downey punting it forward. Will O'Neill make the race? Unfortunately not, as the ball goes harmlessly wide. Calling for the ball as we close of the first half. The scoreboard reading: Slaughter Neil, not 3, Clonoe, 2-3. Throw up for the second half. Clonoe winning the early possession. Colly Doris forward. Colly Donnelly now going forward for Clonoe. Left footed shot. Excellent score by Colin Donnelly. Kelly continuing with the long kickouts. Connor Donnelly picking up the ball to Colly Donnelly. Ball forward, breaks to Martin Hughes, picks the ball up, looking for help. Finds it from Donnelly. Connor Donnelly going forward, laying the ball back. The Slaughter Neil tidying up ball. Bernard Bradley picking up the ball in his 1:45, taking a heavy challenge manfully. Ball slipped back forward. McNally looking for help. Cleverly drops the ball instead of carrying possession. Earns a free. Martin Hughes up to hit the kick. Some 45 metres out. Right footed kick. That's all the way over the bar. Exceptional kick by Martin Hughes. Clonoe winning all the possession in the middle of the field. Their halfbacks, a constant outlet for the possession. The ball's into Ryan O'Neill. O'Neill slips the ball to Colly Donnelly. Colly Donnelly shows the ball. Slips across to David Hanna. Hanna over carrying the ball. Little descent shown by Michael Downey, which is going to result in a hot ball. At this stage of the game, Slaughter Neil really need to keep all the possession they can get. Ball breaks through. Martin Hughes again in possession. What a strong player we have in Shield. The score is exceptional. Right footed kick under pressure, off balance. Slaughter Neil beginning to want a bit more possession in the middle of the park. Niall Convery picking up the ball. Forward to Patsy Bradley. Shane Kelly picking up the ball, carrying down the right wing. Bad distance. distribution and giving the ball to Kevin Doris. Plays a great ball down the wing. McNally opting to play the man instead of the ball, resulting in a free to Slackneil. Barry Bradley to take the kick. Opting back to McIldowney. McIldowney forward to Bradley. Convery now in possession of the ball. Powerful running by this full forward. Left footed kick broken down by Emmett Tague. Tague carrying the ball. Clearing his lines well. Martin Hughes collecting possession from McIldowney. Delicate ball forward to O'Neill. That's an exceptional ball into play. Strikes the ball. Excellent goal. Clonoe now 9 points in front. Starting to dominate the game. Losing all possession in the middle of the park. Clonoe clearing up all loose ball. Marty Hughes with the ball. Strong play. Determined play. Won't give up the ghost. Close at hand we have McIldowney. David Hanna finding himself fouled. Connor Donnelly to take the free. Plays a short free to Marty Hughes. Hughes toying with the defence, gently taps the ball over the bar. For Slackneil. Handling on the ground, free out to Clonoe. Emmett Tague with the ball forward to Doris. Doris holding possession well. A man capable of making time and space for himself in any situation. Hughes this time losing out to McIldowney, who plays a great ball forward to Paul Bradley. Has been given right in the corner. This is going to be a difficult kick should it opt to be taken from the ground. Ball played in short. Conan Cassidy losing possession. Clonoe on hand to clean up the loose ball. Coney carrying the ball out the left wing. Deemed to be carrying too long by the referee. Slackneil have the resulting free kick on the 21-metre line. Wide on the right. O'Neill punts the ball forward. Broken down, well caught by Carr. In the Clonoe goal. Clonoe playing measured ball out of the defence. Colley Donnelly on hand. That's forward to Kevin Doris. Kevin Doris. McIldowney picks up the ball for Slackneil. Carrying forward. Exceptional turn of pace. Opting to go all the way. Ball tidied up by David Hanna for Clonoe. Clonoe introducing Aidan Taggart for the player who sustained an injury. receiving great reception from the crowd. Clunow with the free kick. High ball punted forward. Broken down to Hughes. Hughes in possession. Goes for the 1-2. Going through. Playing the ball across. Connor Donnelly should make it. Unfortunately, Bradley's there first. Gives the ball to O'Neill. Kevin O'Neill. Fists the ball forward to Patsy Bradley. Martin McIlhenny plays it forward to Paul Bradley. Paul Bradley on the left wing. Opting to go for the beating his man. Losing possession. Plays the ball back to Cassidy. Cassidy right footed shot. It's high. Keeper's out. Palming it behind for the 45. By Slatneal. Kevin O'Neill punting the ball forward. And it's over the bar for Slatneal's first score of the second half. They now find themselves 9-point deficit. Bradley to McIldowney. McIldowney forward to Martin McIldowney. Carrying the ball forward. Will he take the shot? That's a fine left footed shot by Martin McIldowney. Slatney will now have their heckles up and are going forward. Kick out himself, going forward well, showing great balance and poise to Patsy Bradley. Plays the ball across to Conan Cassidy. Bradley again. Bradley with the right footed kick. Excellent point. Slatneal is starting to show the kind of determination which won them the trophy last year. By Jason Burns, playing the ball forward to McNally. McNally to Doris. Doris carrying the ball with Terman down the left hand wing. Going away by himself. Slatneal back, gathering possession. In the form of midfielder Bradley, who opts to kick the ball out. Connor Donnelly kicks the sideline, 30 metres out, high ball. Well fielded. Referee giving a hot ball. Bradley in for the hot ball. Clunow gathering possession through Donnelly. Clever 1-2. Donnelly with the kick from, unfortunately, it's wide. Slatneal are now upping the pace with a quick free kick, a quick goal kick. All players not being without side the 21 metre line, it has to be retaken. going down, and Twin Michael Denny going forward with quite a bit of gusto. Drops possession, assisted pass to Kevin O'Neill. Centre half back for Tano, Teague, forward to Donnelly, Colley Donnelly. That's forward. Ryan O'Neill held off the ball to Slatnil, sideline ball. Bernard Bradley in possession. Forward to Michael Downey. Michael Downey to his brother. Going forward. Long ball. Clonoe dealing with the ball. Possession of the premium. Unfortunate Martin Hughes couldn't get to it. Second attempt. Michael Downey. Quite sloppy bit of play. Slatnil earning the resultant free. Kevin O'Neill with the high ball. It's gone harmlessly wide. Gary McCabe coming on for Connor Donnelly. Slanio won the possession. A foul on Martin Michael Downey. A little bit of indiscipline being shown. Players opting to settle up between themselves. Free kick for Slatnil. Dealt with by Clonoe. Ball played forward. Paul O'Neill slips it to the recently introduced McCabe. His first ball was not as accurate as it needed to be. Bradley in possession, going forward for Slatnil. Great forward up. Shane Kelly takes an excellent challenge. Plays the ball to Cassidy. Conan Cassidy. Back to Bradley. Kelly with a soccer style kick going harmlessly wide. Excellent catch by Patsy Bradley for Slatnil. Quite a mysterious free kick being awarded to Clonoe. Patsy Bradley forward to Kevin O'Neill. Slatnil again going forward. Conan Cassidy not first to the ball. Free kick to Clonoe. Clonoe introducing Brian Doris, making way for him. We have number 20, Kevin Doris. Long ball forward. Brian O'Neill well fielded. earning his free. Setting the ball down for the ever-dependable Martin Hughes. Free kick falling short, dealt with by Slatneil. Patsy Bradley putting the ball out over the touchline. McNally out for the ball for Tano. Back to Collie Donnelly. Forward to Doris. Ball is broken down. It's been handled on the ground by Slatneil, resulting in quite an easy 21 metre free for Tano. Again to hit the free. This time he makes no mistake. Slatneil will take the kick. It's gathered by Patsy Bradley. Outside of the right boot, forward to Shane Kelly as co-midfielder. Kelly's going forward. Ball to Comrie. Out to Cassidy. Cassidy quite wastefully kicks the ball wide. Now find themselves 8 points down at 1-6 to 3-8. Approximately 10 minutes of the second half remaining. Jason Burns for Tano. Forward to Teague. Take with the long ball, going out harmlessly over this touchline. The ball is easily dealt with by Emma Teague at centre half back for Tano. High ball forward. Twin McIlhenny back to deal with it. Ball forward, Larry Bradley to Martin McIlhenny. Martin McIlhenny riding the challenge well. Great time in the ball. Finds Conan Cassidy. Slatneil trying to build the play. Cassidy with a left footed kick, and it's an excellent score. Slatneil introducing Sean Gillen for Fergal McIlhenny. Doris is playing a fine bit of close control, slips the ball, gets a return, first time ball, fouled in the process. Patsy Bradley finding his way into the notebook. referee content with just a quiet word. Possession. Hughes to McCabe. Collie Donnelly. It's a fine score by Clonoe. Down in possession for Slattin Hill. Slips the ball to Larry Bradley. Larry Bradley to Kevin O'Neill. O'Neill with the high ball forward. Niall Convery first to the ball. No option but to lay it out for Conan Cassidy. Cassidy to Bradley. To Patsy Bradley. Free kick forward. Oh, well dealt with. Corr did well in goal for Clonoe. Clonoe continuing to go forward. McCabe. Clonoe up to keep possession. Ryan O'Neill fouled as he went for the ball. Clonoe now starting to use their head and slow down the play. Hughes with the free kick. Right foot it. Dealt with the Slattin Hill defence. Michael Downey in possession. 2-0. Long ball forward to Shane Kelly. Kelly in possession. Dealt with by Clonoe with ease. Jason Burns forward for Clonoe to Paul O'Neill. Quite wastefully kicking the ball away to Bernard Bradley. Bradley forward to Patrick Bradley, resulting in a Slattin Hill sideline ball. Patrick Bradley with the kick to Conan Cassidy. Cassidy gathers possession, slips the ball to Martin McIldowney. Determined runner, touched in the back, resulting in a free kick. The quick free taken. McIldowney drills a ball over the bar. Obviously going for the goal.
Second point.
Paul O'Neill gathering possession for Clonoe. Punted ball forward. Crosses this aid lane. Danny McMullen to kick for Slattin Hill. Conan Cassidy down in the ball. Forward to Kearney. Kearney outside of the right boot. Marty Hughes on hand for Clonoe. This man is sterling performance and man of the match. Forward to Ryan Rambo O'Neill. He quite wastefully kicks the ball left and wide. Clonoe winning the kick out. Collie Donnelly. Donnelly giving the ball to his midfield partner Doris. Doris with the right footed kick. It's high. Ryan O'Neill latching on. Free kick to Slattin Hill. It's taken to Patsy Bradley. beats his man, giving the ball to Michael Downey. Michael Downey fists the ball forward, Larry Bradley determined to run, earning the free as he went down for the ball. Emma Teig dealing with the ball. He's had an exceptional performance at centre half back for Clonoe. Sean Gillan for Slattery to Larry Bradley. Bradley with the long ball forward. Shane Kelly breaking the ball, dealt with by Clonoe. Gary McCabe with the ball for Clonoe, carrying the ball, keeping possession. Beats a man, still in possession of the ball. Beats another man. Fine run by McCabe. Excellent point by Gary McCabe. Second half substitute starting to show his worth. And what was an exceptional game of football, Clonoe found themselves the victors, 3-10 to Slattery's 1-8, an 8-point margin of victory. Man of the match for Clonoe, without doubt, was Martin Hughes. Centre half forward.
What a day.
First of all, I'd like to say both teams have been great hard to the game. Congratulations. Our next referees are Owen and Brian McCallan from here in Greenlaw. And also mention our other two referees who couldn't be here today, and that's Martin McAleen from Ballinderry and Tom McCain from Castle Dawson. I'm going to ask Willie John McCann here to come forward and present the medals to runners-up, and that's Slattery. Everybody give him a big round of applause. Session with the Clonoe captain, going to get an Irish news. In about a week's time or so, and at that stage we'll get you the voucher for the set of jerseys. We can now ask Woolly John McCann to present the McCann Memorial Cup to the one in captain, Barry McNally. I think it would be very unfair, especially when a throne of friendly going over in Derry, not to let Barry say a few words.
What can you say, Rick? Rick, thank you, Greenlaw, for running the tournament and inviting us to it. I'd like to thank Slough Neil for a good hard game. That's basically it. Thanks very much.
Congratulations to Haswadra down here, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to change it. So, that's congratulations to the winners. And thanks to the Green Love Club for all the work we put into this, to organising this tournament. And the memory of Sean and Paul. And for filling Paul's dream of a competition like this for the under-21s. The family wish to wish the Green Love Club and all the clubs that took part every success in the future. Thank you.